गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू साइंस लेसन नंबर 1, द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम। ह्यूमन बॉडी कंसिस्ट अप ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स एज वेल एज इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स। एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स विच आर प्लेस्ड आउटसाइड आर बॉडी लाइक आर सेंस ऑर्गन्स। सेंस ऑर्गन्स लाइक ईयर्स, नोज, दीज ऑल आर एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स। एंड इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स विच आर प्लेस्ड इनसाइड आर बॉडी विच वी कैन नॉट सी, they are inside our body like the kidneys, the heart, lungs, all these are internal organs. And these external organs and internal organs together they make up the human body. Next we have to do organ system. When a group of organs work together, the system is known as organ system. A group of organs working together make up an organ system. Now we have to start with the circulatory system. Circulatory system, from the word circulation, they help to circulate the digested food, the blood throughout our body, and waste material also are removed with the help of this circulatory system. Circulatory system is made up of three parts: heart, blood and blood vessels. The main part of the circulatory system, the most important part, is the heart, then blood and blood vessels. Blood is further divided into two parts: plasma and blood cells. Blood cells are of three types: RBC, red blood cells, WBC, white blood cells, and platelets. Then blood vessels are of two types: arteries and veins. Arteries carry pure blood or the oxygenated blood. Veins, they carry impure blood or deoxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood is carried by the arteries, which means blood containing more of oxygen. Blood containing oxygen is carried by the arteries. And veins, they carry deoxygenated blood, that means the blood which has more of carbon dioxide is carried by the veins. Now we will study about the main part of the circulatory system, the heart. The heart is the key organ in the circulatory system. The main function of the heart is to pump the blood throughout the body. And a heart beats about 72 times a minute. It keeps pumping the blood. While we are sleeping, the heart pumps blood slowly. And if we are running or exercising, walking fast, then the heart beats faster. Oxygen is needed by our bodies at rest. When we are exercising, the heart pumps blood faster. Next, we have to do the structure of the heart. The heart is a fist size muscular organ, about the size of our fist. If you close your fingers, you will get the fist. So heart is of the size of the fist. The two main parts of the heart are atrium and ventricle. Heart has two main parts, atrium and ventricle. Atrium is the upper part, ventricle is the lower part. Atrium is further divided into two: right atrium and left atrium. And ventricle also divided into two parts: right ventricle and left ventricle. So the heart has total four chambers: right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle. Heart has total four chambers and it is placed inside the rib cage, in between the two lungs. It beats 72 times a minute. One heartbeat, it comprises one contraction and one relaxation. On contraction, the blood inside the heart is pumped out. While the heart relaxes, the blood enters the chambers of the heart. Deoxygenated blood from the body cells, the deoxygenated blood which is having more of carbon dioxide, enters the right side of the heart, right ventricle and right atrium. Deoxygenated blood enters the right side, right atrium and right ventricle. And then from here it goes to the lungs for collecting oxygen. Then oxygenated blood from the lungs enters the left ventricle and left atrium, left side of the heart. The oxygenated blood enters from the left side inside the heart, from where it is pumped to different parts of the body. Next, we have to do process of circulation. The muscles of the heart, they contract and relax continuously. One contraction and one relaxation of the muscles make one heartbeat. The right atrium and ventricle receive deoxygenated blood from the body. The right atrium and the right ventricle, they receive deoxygenated blood from the body, and left atrium and left ventricle, they receive oxygenated blood from the lungs. Oxygenated blood means the blood which is rich in oxygen. The heart contracts to send the deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood reaches the right side of the heart, right atrium and right ventricle. Then the heart will contract to send this deoxygenated blood to the lungs for purification. In the lungs, the blood will absorb oxygen and get rid of carbon dioxide. When it relaxes, the deoxygenated blood from the main vein enters the heart, and oxygenated blood comes from the lungs to the left atrium and left ventricle, left side of the heart. The oxygenated blood from the lungs will reach the left ventricle. Now the process of circulation, this is important. See, deoxygenated blood from the body, from whole of our body, the deoxygenated blood which is rich in carbon dioxide, it reaches the right ventricle. It reaches the right ventricle. From the right ventricle, the blood is pumped, blood is sent to the lungs. Inside the lungs, because we keep on continuously breathing, inside the lungs, the blood will absorb oxygen and release CO2. Blood becomes oxygenated inside the lungs, and then this oxygenated blood is sent to the left ventricle. From the left ventricle, the oxygenated blood enters the heart. From the heart, it is sent to all parts of our body, from the head to the toe. This is the process of circulation, how the circulation of blood takes place in our bodies. Next, we come to blood vessels. Blood vessels are basically of two types, arteries and veins. Arteries carry oxygenated blood. Arteries, they carry oxygenated blood from the heart to all the parts of the body. And veins, they carry deoxygenated blood which is which has more of carbon dioxide, is carried by the veins, and it is carried from throughout the body to the heart. Veins carry deoxygenated blood to the heart from all parts of our body. Arteries, they carry blood with more oxygen, and blood with more oxygen is known as oxygenated blood. Arteries are thick walled and red in color. Arteries are red in color. They are divided into small network of blood vessels known as capillaries. Then veins, second type of blood vessels are veins. Veins carry deoxygenated blood, or blood which is having more of carbon dioxide, from all parts of the body. Veins are thin walled and veins are shown with blue color. Capillaries, they connect the arteries and the veins. They are further branched. They form a network through our body. They are thin branches of arteries and veins, which are spread throughout our body. Capillaries of arteries and veins are interconnected, making the circulatory system a closed system. Then differences between arteries and veins. The first difference between arteries and veins is arteries carry oxygenated blood, veins carry deoxygenated blood. Arteries are thick-walled and veins are thin-walled. Arteries carry blood away from the heart. Arteries carry oxygenated blood away from the heart, and veins carry deoxygenated blood to the heart. Inside the arteries, blood flows with high pressure. In the arteries, blood flows with high pressure, and in the veins, blood flows with low pressure. So we have completed the blood vessels and structure of heart, process of circulation. The next part of circulatory system is blood. In the flowchart before, we have done blood is made up of two parts, plasma and blood cells. Plasma, it is the liquid content of the blood. Plasma comprises about 92% of the blood, and blood cells are further or divided into three types of blood cells. Blood cells are the solid part. Blood cells are of three types: red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Red blood cells, they are known as RBCs. They transport food, oxygen, and other nutrients to all parts of the body. Red blood cells, they supply nutrients and oxygen to all parts of the body, and they help to remove waste from the body cells. Then second type of blood cell is WBCs. WBCs help us to fight against the germs and foreign particles which enter the body. The third type of blood cell is platelets. Platelets help in clotting of blood. In case of wounds, platelets will help in clotting of blood at the time of cuts or wounds. So we have completed blood. Blood is, remember, made up of plasma and blood cells. Plasma is the liquid part, which is 92% of the blood, and blood cells are the solid part of the blood made up of RBC, WBC, and platelets. Next, we have to do functions of circulatory system. Circulatory system, it helps to circulate. From the word circulatory, it helps to circulate the digested food and oxygen to all parts of the body, to all the body cells, and it helps to collect the waste materials and carbon dioxide from different parts of the body. Second function of circulatory system is it transports the digested food from the small intestine. From the small intestine, the digested food, all the nutrients are absorbed by the walls of the small intestine. From the small intestine, transportation of the nutrients and digested food is done by blood to different parts of the body. It helps to transport the nutrients to all parts of the body. Then third function is extra water from the large intestine is carried by the blood back to the kidneys for filtration. Fourth, the circulatory system, it helps to maintain our body temperature. And last function is the white blood cells inside the blood, they help to fight against the germs and bacteria in the body and keep our body free from infectious diseases. Next part is lungs. Lungs are a pair of air-filled sacs located on both the sides of our chest. Lungs, they help in breathing. Inhalation and exhalation takes place with the help of lungs. When we inhale, we take in oxygen-rich air inside our lungs. Inside our lungs, the lungs expand when we inhale air. And lungs, they contract, they shrink when we exhale air. Exhale, we exhale out carbon dioxide, which is not required by our bodies. And we inhale the air which is rich in oxygen. Oxygen is absorbed by the blood, and carbon dioxide is sent by the, given out by the blood vessels in the lungs, and then by exhalation that CO2 is breathed out. As you inhale, all the sacs, air sacs inside the lungs get filled up with air. As we exhale, the air sacs shrink and air is pushed out. Now, how the circulatory system works? When we breathe in, when we inhale air, what happens? The air, when we inhale, it reaches our lungs. And from the heart also, the deoxygenated blood from the right atrium and right ventricle is pumped to the lungs. When we inhale, we take in oxygen-rich air. Air which is rich in oxygen, there the deoxygenated blood, it sends out CO2 and absorbs oxygen inside the lungs. The blood mixes with the oxygen after we inhale air, and then this oxygen-rich air is sent to the left ventricle. From the left ventricle, then the oxygenated blood is pumped throughout our bodies with the help of arteries. The blood cells also pick up waste like carbon dioxide and bring it back to the lungs so that we can exhale out carbon dioxide and get rid of the excess of carbon dioxide in the blood. Now, how do we keep our heart healthy? If we want to keep our heart healthy, exercising plays an important role. If we exercise or walk daily, then the heart remains healthy and it becomes stronger. Walking for 30 minutes a day can make a big difference in our life. Deep breathing or pranayam or yoga, doing yoga can also help to strengthen the heart. Pranayam is a breathing technique. It helps to improve the circulation of blood. Then it calms the mind, releases stress and depression. So we can keep our heart healthy if we walk daily and if we exercise daily, especially for the heart and breathing. If we do pranayam daily, it will help in circulation and it will improve our circulatory system. With this, we have completed lesson number 1. Next, we will continue with lesson number 2, the skeletal system. Our body has many systems, and skeletal system is one of the important systems of our body, as it gives framework and support to the internal organs of our body. It provides framework to our body. It is a framework of bones that give shape to our body. The shape of our body is because of the presence of the skeleton. It gives shape to our body, and bones join together to form the skeleton. The whole skeleton of our body, it is basically, it consists up of skull on the top, then spine, our backbone, rib cage, limbs, both the hands and legs are included in this, limbs and joints. All these things together make up the skeletal system of our body, and the joints are of 4 types: hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint and sliding joint. Hinge joint, it is present in the elbow and knee. Ball and socket joint, present in the shoulder and hip. Pivot joint, it is a joint between our skull and the first vertebrae at the back. Sliding joint, it is present in the spine and our wrists. Sliding joint is present. Now, this skeletal system, it is made up of bones. Bones are made up of two important elements, calcium and phosphorus. Along with calcium and phosphorus, vitamins and water also keep our bones healthy and strong. Bones are made up of calcium and phosphorus. Bones are hard and give our body support as well as protection. They support our body, give protection to the internal organs, to the important internal organs. Like the skull, it protects our brain. Spine protects our spinal cord. So they protect the internal organs, the rib cage, it protects the lungs as well as the heart, which are the important organs. So the skeletal system helps to protect the organs also, and it gives shape and framework to our body. Bone, inside of the bone, bone marrow is present. Bone marrow is the soft spongy part which is present inside the hard bones, and bone marrow has a network of blood capillaries and consists up of blood. Bones keep growing as we grow. So the as you grow taller, it is because of the growth of your bones. So in order to grow taller, you have to have more of calcium in your diet so that your bones also grow in length and you also become taller. Calcium, phosphorus, vitamins as well as water help to keep our bones healthy and strong. Now first we will start with skull. Skull is made up of 22 bones in all. In all, the human body, an adult human body contains about, it is made up of about 206 bones. In an adult human skeleton, the skeletal system consists up of all the bones in our body as well as in our joints. Now skull is made up of 22 bones. Total 22 bones are present in the skull. In the upper part of the skull, there are 8 flat bones which are joined together to make the upper part of the skull. The skull protects our brain, and then in our face and jaw, total 14 bones are present. The lower jaw is the only part of the skull which we are able to move. And our teeth are rooted in the jaws. The skull protects the brain as well as the sense organ. Brain is present in the upper part inside the skull, and our sense organs like the eyes, nose, ears are protected by the remaining part of the skull. Next is spine. Spine is also known as backbone. Commonly we call it as backbone. Our spine has 33 small bones. Each bone of the spine is known as vertebra. The 33 small bones are stacked, are kept one on top of the other, and it has a hole in the center. Each vertebra has a hole in the center through which the spinal cord passes. The spine protects our spinal cord. Spinal cord, from the spinal cord, a number of nerves go throughout our bodies. Each bone has a hole through which the spinal cord passes. Spine protects the spinal cord. The third is rib cage. Rib cage is present in our chest, and it is made up of 12 pairs of bones. At the back, the rib cage is attached to the spine. In the front, the rib cage is attached to the bones of the rib cage, they are attached to the breastbone. There are total 12 pair of thin curved bones, and inside the rib cage, the lungs and heart are protected. The last two pairs of ribs are not attached to the breastbone, so they are known as floating ribs. Rib cage, it protects the lungs and the heart. Next, we come to the limbs. Limbs are our hands and legs. Hands and legs are known as limbs. In our hands, the upper part of our hands, forearm, it is made up of a big bone known as humerus. The next, below the elbow, there are two bones joined together, and our hands, fingers are made up of a number of bones. Same way in our legs, the upper part, the thigh, it is made up of the longest bone, which is known as femur. Below the knees, there are two bones joined together, and in our toe area, in our foot, there are a number of bones. Thighs are attached to the hip girdle, and hip girdle also, the backbone ends up in the hip girdle, and thighs, the femur bone also fits in and forms the ball and socket joint in the hip girdle. Next, we come to importance of bones. What is the importance of bones? Bones, they provide framework to our body, they provide shape to our body. Second importance is they protect the internal organs, delicate internal organs like the skull. It protects the brain and our eyes, ears. Rib cage protects the lungs and the heart. Then spine protects the spinal cord. Hip girdle, it supports the stomach, intestine and other organs. Next, we come to types of muscles. Bones cannot move on their own. Bones are attached to muscles, and muscles help the bones to move. They also help in digestion. Muscles help us to breathe in and breathe out. Smile, frown, all this is done with the help of muscles. Now, we have, our body has three types of muscles: voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles, and cardiac muscles. Voluntary muscles, first type, voluntary muscles, they are present in our hands and our legs. They are under our control. When we want to walk, we can walk. When we want to sit down or run, we can run. When we want to lift our hands, so all these hands and legs, movement of the hands and legs are because of the voluntary muscles present in our limbs. Our arms, legs, hands and feet have voluntary muscles. They are total in our control. These muscles are in our control and we can move it according to our will. Voluntary muscles are long and cylindrical. They are known as striped muscles. They are known as striped muscles present in our hands and legs. They are long and cylindrical. That is why, and they have bands. That is why they are known as striped muscles. They have bands all over. That is why they are called striped muscles. Second type of muscles are involuntary muscles. Involuntary muscles are not in our control. We cannot control these involuntary muscles. They are present in the stomach, food pipe, and intestine. They are known as smooth muscles. They don't have stripes, so they are known as smooth muscles. They are short and spindle shaped. Voluntary muscles are cylindrical, but involuntary muscles are spindle shaped and short. They are known as smooth muscles. The third type is cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles are branched. You can see in the figure, it is branched. Cardiac muscles are branched. They look like voluntary muscles, The only difference is they are branched and they are present in our heart. They work all through our lives, pumping blood through our body. They help in pumping blood throughout our body because cardiac muscles are present in the heart. Next, we come to importance of joints. Joints are of two types: movable joints and immovable joints. Movable joints, which are able to move, and immovable joints, they are present in our ribs and in our skull. Immovable joints, which we cannot move. Movable joints can be moved, which help in giving movement to the bones, are known as movable joints. The bones are held at a joint with the help of strong tissues known as ligaments. Bones are held together at the joints with the help of ligaments. A ligament is like a strong strap. Our body makes a special liquid that oils our joints. Oily liquid is present in the joints, especially like the knees and elbow. Some oily liquid is present, which helps in the proper movement of the joint. Joints are of four types. Hinge joint. Hinge joint allows the body part to move only in one direction, like our elbows. In our elbows, hinge joint is present. We can move our elbows we can move the hand only in the one direction. So it is a hinge joint is present at the elbow and knee. Then second is ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joint present in our shoulders and our hips. Please keep learning the examples also. Ball and socket joint is present in our shoulders and our hips. And in such joint, the round ball-like end of a bone rotates and moves in the socket of the girdle bone. Third is pivot joint. Pivot joint is present between the skull and the first vertebra. This joint occurs where the skull meets the first vertebra. It allows some amount of circular motion, up and down movement. We can move our head up and down because of the pivot joint. Then fourth is sliding joint, also known as the gliding joint. It is present in our spine, in our wrist. In our wrist also sliding joint or gliding joint is present, and our ankle. Between the vertebras in the spine, this sliding joint is present. Next, we come to functions of the skeletal system. The skeletal system is made up of 206 bones in an adult human body. Total 206 bones are present in adult human body. All these bones together make up the skeletal system. And bones, they give shape and support to the delicate organs. They support the delicate organs, provide a framework to our body. They protect the delicate organs of the body. Red blood cells and platelets are made inside the bone marrow, the soft spongy part inside the bones. And bones allow movement of the different body parts, the different joints. They allow movement of the different body parts. How do we care for our bones and joints? First of all, we should have a balanced diet. Basically, our diet should include a lot of calcium for the healthy and strong bones. We need to have proper calcium vitamins in our diet. A healthy diet is good for your joints because it helps you to build strong bones and muscles. Checking your weight is the best you can do for your joints. Exercise can help you reduce and maintain a healthy weight. Good posture also helps you to keep the hip joint and back muscles. For your bones, you should take enough of calcium every day. Calcium, it is best amount of calcium is present in milk and yogurt. Dairy products, cereals, soy milk are good sources of calcium. Oranges also give your joints a healthy boost. Vitamin C and other antioxidants can keep your joints healthy. So you should have maximum amount of, good amount of calcium, vitamin D, vitamin C, and foods rich in phosphorus also help in the better development of your bones and joints. With this, we have finished lesson number 2, the skeletal system. We will continue with the lesson number 3 in the next class. Up till then, children, please revise and read lesson number 1 and 2. Go through the exercises and question answers. Thank you, class.